My name is Renee Johnson, and I'm a member of Claremont United Methodist Church. I represent Group 9, who was a group of people that came together to try to answer the questions on this sheet. And since I have always struggled with trying to have my voice heard, I felt that when you told me we should come up here and speak on behalf of our group, I felt called that I needed to be the first one. Because I'm an LGBT, and I've always had a desire to have my voice heard, because I feel that it's never been heard in the church. And what this meeting means goes far beyond my perception. And I feel so blessed sitting next to you, Bishop, because I'm trying to catch your energy, trying to get it merged into my spirit for moving forward. And hopefully that will give me strength to represent my group. It was just wonderful. We actually broke down, what does biblical obedience mean to you? We broke down two words. We broke down what the Bible meant to us, and we also broke down what obedience meant to us. And it was shared that the Bible is a book of parables, stories, and themes. In the early church, it talked about diversity. The words were like threads intertwined with life. It was really good to talk about how this was a period of transformation and change. How it's a period of transition of culture and diversity, that when we combine the biblical obedience together, we kind of had problems with obedience, because our group challenged that and said that biblical obedience could be a political term used to make people suffer, and we don't want to do that, so we weren't really in agreement with the word obedience. We thought maybe it could be something towards making decisions based on what Jesus did, having the Bible not necessarily as our primary authority, but having the Holy Spirit guide us, and how the Ten Commandments laid our foundation, and that Christ really wasn't confined to a box, that he is so much more, and so much more out of the box, that, you know, having us look beyond what is our immediate parameters. When it came to how would that manifest in our midst, I talked to the group and just had them explain it with one word. Dispel the myth, welcome, invitation to participate, acceptance, radical love. And what's currently going on in our church is just the simple concept of revolution. That we're in the midst of a revolution. It's beyond neutral. It's being beloved, inclusive, reconciliation. When we talked about what do we do when the biblical obedience is in conflict with the book of discipline, we're looking for a new map. We're looking for a new guidance. We talked about how an image came forth, how there's a tree that builds our foundation from the trunk, connecting it to the earth, and how it's fruit-bearing, and that we need to look at bearing good fruit so that it will replenish, and that we can grow and learn by our elders, and that we can teach the children from the ground up and continue this cycle of life in a more loving fashion. If it calls